What's the difference between 3D and fake 3D? Well, fake, or in distinguished French, faux, says it all. It creates the illusion of three dimensions. We make something look like it actually isn't. Basically our job, right? In After Effects, you can do both real 3D and fake 3D. In your comp settings, you have the option to use the Cinema 4D renderer or advanced renderer, but they come with a lot of restrictions. And even more important, fake 3D is a graphic style. You can create surprising moments in animations if you suddenly break out of your flat 2D design and create a 3D moment, in transitions for example. In this tutorial, I'll show you different ways to create the illusion of three dimensions. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. For all our comps, we use the classic 3D renderer. To warm up, let's create a 3D text without using 3D layers. It's magic. I've already added a text to my comp. We duplicate the text layer and add CC Light Burst 2.5. Let's quickly search for it in the Effects and Presets window and drag it onto the bottom text layer. Intensity 200, ray length around minus 200, depending on how long you want the shadow to be. Burst, fade, and let's set the color. Let's choose purple. The center point position determines the direction of the shadow. To turn the light rays into a solid shape, we use matte choker. Geometric softness 1, 0, choke 1, minus 127. All the other properties, 0, except iterations, 1. The center determines the perspective. Looks like something it isn't? Check. Did you know there are a lot more resources on my website? Check out my courses. Develop motion design strategies for brands. Learn how to create smooth animations or how to animate with expressions in After Effects. Sign up to my newsletter, get your free expression sheet, or download more than 150 After Effects project files. The link is in the description. The difference between two and three dimensions is depth. Take a flat 2D scene, add depth, and it looks like 3D. Color gradients, lights, and shadows make all the difference. Let's see how to do this. We quickly create a new round shape by double-clicking on the ellipse tool. Let's name the layer Sun. Size 400 by 400 pixels. As fill, we use a linear gradient. Choose two colors, a pink-orange as the brighter color, and a dark purple. We adjust the start and end of the gradient by moving these two blue handles into a diagonal gradient direction. To turn it into an illusion of a sphere, we use layer styles. Let's choose bevel and emboss. Let's adjust the settings, inner bevel, smooth, direction, up. Let's set the size to around 10. Soften, 16, the max value. Angle around 140 degrees. So that the bright part aligns with the bright part of the gradient. We use a bright pink as highlight color and a dark blue as shadow color. Next, let's add a second layer style. Inner shadow. We use a dark blue as color. Angle around 300 degrees. We need to increase the distance to around 60. Size around 115. And that adds volume and turns it into a sphere. And let's add some noise. 5%. It looks like a sphere. Let's duplicate the layer, name it Planet. And we shrink its size to 150 pixels width and height. Let's hide the sun for now, then adjust the start and end of the gradient fill. Let's change the colors as well, and use a light gray and a very dark, almost black blue. Next, we need to adjust the inner shadow settings. Let's shrink the size to around 50, the distance to around 30. It is important to know that layer styles don't work with 3D layers, but we need to use 3D layers to rotate the planet around the sun. To work around that, we pre-compose the two layers. Pre-sun and right-click on the layer, pre-compose, pre-planet. Then we add a null object and turn all layers into 3D layers. We move the planet to the right and link it to the null object. We open the rotation property of the null and animate, not the Z direction, but the Y direction of the null with an expression. You can see it gets smaller and disappears behind the sun. We add an expression to the property, time asterisk 50. At the same time, we need to rotate the sphere itself in the opposite direction, time asterisk minus 50, so that it keeps facing the camera. We created the illusion of a three-dimensional scene. The link to the project file is in the description. A sphere? Easy. But how about a hemisphere? We double-click on the ellipse tool again to create a sphere. Size 500 by 500 pixels. Let's keep the colors of the gradient, adjust the start and end of it. Let's name it Cut. Then turn the layer into a 3D layer. Rotate it along the x-axis by 90 degrees. This is like the inside of the sphere, the cutting area. Then we duplicate it. Name it Hemisphere and rotate it back to zero. You can see we need to cut this shape in half to get the rounded half of the sphere. We open the path property and convert the path into a Bezier path. Then delete the top path point. We use the selection tool to select the left point. Then use the convert vertex tool to turn the upper edge into a straight line. Same with the right point. Hold shift to get the exact 90 degree angle. Finally, we link the two layers together. We created the illusion of a hemisphere. Make sure to check out the links in the description to explore more incredibly helpful resources. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.